Okay, firstly, I want to thank the organizers for giving me a chance to give a talk at this wonderful conference. And I'm from POSTECH Korea, and I want to show you our results on the temperature evolution of the Fermi surface in the periodic Anderson model with the dynamical mean field theory approach. We start from the neighbor of the Kang insulator, which is the heavy Fermi metal. For example, you can see here the left-hand side, the phase diagram of the cerium rhodium indium 5. If you apply the external magnetic, external pressure to the sample, then you can suppress the anti-ferromagnetic ground state of them and induce some unconventional superconductivity. And in the right side, can see the phase diagram of the ytterbium rhodium to silicon 2, then if you apply the external magnetic field, then you can also suppress the anti-ferromagnetic ground state of it and induce some heavy fermi-leaky state and in between the non-fermi-leaky state. So schematically, you can always see that for the heavy fermions, you can, if you suppress by increasing some kind of tuning parameter, the anti-ferromagnetic ground state, then you can get the heavy fermi-leaky state with the Kondo lattice effect and in between some unveiled non-fermi-leaky states. So in this research, we concentrated on the right-hand side of the phase diagram, which means that in the Kondo lattice effect. So in the right-hand side, the Kondo exchange, Kondo lattice effect dominates the physics of the phase diagram. And if you see the Fermi surface of them, because it is a metal, so at the low temperature, because of the Kondo lattice effect, the F electrons are itinerant and contribute to the conduction, so it has a large Fermi surface. And but at high temperature, the F electrons are local, so it does not contribute to the conduction, so it has a very small Fermi surface relatively. And there exists some kind of previous theoretical suggestions that there may exist some multiple temperature scales if you vary the temperature in between them. So we studied the temperature evolution of the Fermi liquid, heavy Fermi liquid state, and we changed the temperature and doping effects. So we studied the periodic Anderson model in the two-dimensional scale lattice with the dynamical mean field theory. So, and we studied both the Kondo and mixed balance region, and the total occupancy of the system is fixed by 1.92, which is slightly below the half-field case. So in this case, this is the heavy fermion metal in the Kondo region. So Kondorism is that in our case, the lower and upper Hubbert bands are well splitted, and they are far from the thermal level of the conduction band. So in the self-energy, you can see that the system, if you decrease the temperature from the pink to purple, then you can see that your system, or the F electron, tends to be more coherent and more minimalized. And if you see the density of states, then you can find that the F electron density of states grows, develops more sharp peak at the thermal level, which is the Kondo, which is the sign of the Kondo effect, at the lower temperature. And it, you can see also the effect in the conduction band density of states. So it, and you can see that the NF, F electron occupancy is not temperature dependent because it is strictly in the Kondo region, so the F electron occupancy is exactly 1.0 in this case. And if you see the Fermi surfaces, then you can see that starting from the high temperature, which is the small Fermi surface, you can observe a continuous kind of transition from the small Fermi surface to large Fermi surface. And this is the band structure you can see also. But you can see that here, there exists some kind of two temperature scales. One is the temperature scale or the energy scale of the increasement of the Fermi surface area itself. And but you can see here that at the later temperature scale, which is lower than the previous temperature scale, the Fermi surface tends to be more coherent rather than the area increases. So we can say that there may exist some two kind of temperature scales. One is the so-called local Kondo temperature, TK. At the temperature scale, the Fermi surface area, it starts to increase continuously. And the other lower temperature scale, which is called coherence temperature, an effective mass, or the coherency of the Fermi surface, starts to increase. And actually, this result is quite agrees with the previous DFT plus DMFT study for the cerium iridium-indium 5. So you can see that there exist two kind of temperature scales for the Fermi surface area and the effectiveness. So nextly, we move on to the mixed balance regime. So the mixed balance regime is achieved by some lowering the total F electron levels. So in this case, the upper Hilbert band, you can see here, is touching the conduction band. So in this case, you can see that in the self-energy of the F electrons, in the very similar temperature range of the previous condor region case, they are all very coherent. It means that the kind of coherence temperature scale is higher than that of the condor region. And actually, I think it is very natural because the condo exchange strength is inversely proportional to the energy difference of the F2 and F1 state, but in the mixed balance region, the energy difference is very smaller than that of the condo region, so it has a very higher condo exchange. So the coherence scale is very, very much higher than that of the condo region. And if you see the density of states, you can see that there is some kind of condo-like, condo peak, at the Fermi level, and you have a larger hybridization gap. So the gap is not less reasonable. And you can see here that in the conduction band density of state, the spectrum continuously evolves to the right-hand side of the density of state. It means that the NF and NC may be temperature dependent in this region, different from the condor region. So if you plot the NF, which means the F electron occupancy here, to the inverse temperature. If you start from the very high temperature, then your system is in the mixed balance region, which means that NF is almost 1.3 something. But if you decrease the temperature, then it tends to decrease and seems to be converging to the 1.0, which means the condor region. So we suggest that if you start from the mixed balance state, then your F, and in this case, NF equals about 1.2, so it means that F1 level is still below the, still has less energy than the F2 level. But your temperature is large enough, then your system has some kind of mixed kind of states of the F1 and F2, and it shows a mixed balance state with the NF equals 1 point something. But if you decrease the temperature more and more, even below the coherence temperature scale, then your system F electron occupancy starts to change. So then it converges at the infinitely low temperature. Your system may show some condor lattice-like behavior with the integer F electron occupancy. So this is the end of my presentation and this conclusion, and you can see more details in my poster number 18. Thank you very much.
Okay, we have 5 minutes for questions.
It's very interesting, of course. Is there some way to, kind of pedagogical way to understand the evolution of the mixed valence state to the condo state just by changing the temperature?
I think if your temperature is sufficiently high, then it means that the occupancy of the F1 state and the F2 state has some kind of variance according to some kind of Boltzmann factor or whatever. So it is the mixed balance. But if you lower the temperature, then still, because your F2 state is in the higher level than the F1 state, so your system has is occupied by only the F1 configuration. It means the condo. So in my opinion, this kind of explanation is possible.
So just to be sure, so you're really seeing quite large changes in the occupation number of the Fs and the conduction electrons as you're changing the temperature.
Yes.
Is that something you would expect in a general way, or it's peculiar to this particular model, or Or you're not sure?
I think, in my opinion, it is general.
Yeah.
If your system has a lower level, F1 level, than the F2 level, for example.
I was wondering the distance of your weapons is more as you, isn't it?
The energy difference of F1 and F2, in this case, it is about 0.5 D. D means the half bit.
Okay, yes. I see.
Yeah, at the temperature scales you're looking at, is there any significant difference between the lattice and the single impurity physics?
In the single impurity physics, I think the local quantum temperature exists. Yeah, but because it is a lattice, so there exists some kind of coherence band structure of the.
But the point that you've just made about the temperature being between EF1 and EF2. Was discussed by Wilson, Krishnamurti, and Wilkins in their single impurity work using renormalization group. And so I wonder whether that aspect of the physics you're seeing here is the same as you have in single impurity.
I don't have any specific idea of that.
Okay.
Any more questions?
So in principle, somebody doing photo emission on some system should see such a strong temperature dependence of the occupation. I mean, that would be the implication that this is a kind of a general idea.
You get it pretty hot.
Yeah. Very interesting.
Okay, that's thanks to be here again.